If you go to Tulane and are rocking an orange Slugs hat, if you can report to the announcer's booth, that'd be great. Oh, that's adorable. Your brother kept on talking about you guys, and now all you guys can talk about is your brother? That is so adorable. Love that. As always, we've got some interesting giveaways here at AVP Next Gold, and of course, AVP America. The photo contest, just post to Instagram. You need to follow AVP America and tag AVP America for the most interesting, creative, all around awesome picture. We'll be selected as a winner, but you make sure to use the hashtag AVP Beach Week. Once again, post to Instagram. You need to follow AVP America as well as tag in your photo AVP America. Just comment and use the hashtag AVP Beach Week, and you could go home a lucky winner of some amazing prizes from AVP America.
16U are looking for the team of Sides and Whisnack. Report number three, please. Sides and Whisnack. Report number three.
We are just 5 minutes away from go time here on center court. That's right, 14U gold championships right here. This is the final for the girls, the ladies 14U division gold championships. We are 5 minutes away from start time, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, a reminder, we do have an awesome photo contest. You can go home with some awesome prizes courtesy of AVP America. Just post your most interesting, funny, creative, and appropriate photos to Instagram. Make sure you're following AVP America and tag AVP America in your photo while using the hashtag AVP Beach Week. Lucky winners will be selected each day to go home with some free swag courtesy of AVP America. Logan here cheering on his twin sisters. You can tell by the distinctive haircut, he's hard to miss. Oh, Tiernan, I'm not going to forget about you. Don't worry, buddy. I know you feel left out. Don't worry, you're left in. All day, buddy. I just find it adorable that your brothers mentioned you, and then you're going, our brothers won yesterday. I'm like, oh, you guys get along so well. Wish I had that at my house. Just saying. Players to their boxes, please, as we get set to start out this 14U gold medal championship match. Ladies and gentlemen, and volleyball fans of every age, it's now time for our 14U championship match of the gold division. Hailing to us from West Palm Beach, Florida, we've got a set of twins who are so proud of their brother, they want to mention him at every chance. First, bring him out from the Team Sandstorm, Brayton Taylor. And they don't call her Bree Whisper, that's right, her twin sister, Brielle Taylor. All right, and their competition in today's matchup coming to us from Virginia. First, from Winchester, that's right, Lock and Load. A member of Blue Ridge Volleyball, give it up for Miss Emma Blythe. And from Roanoke, Virginia, her partner playing for VA Sand, give it up for Kaylee Pyle.
From Atlantic City, New Jersey, VSN and the AVP, bringing you the AVP 14 and under Junior Nationals from Atlantic City. And we're just about ready to go. Paul Boron along with Victoria Dennis. And we're looking forward to this, the first of three finals, and they're just getting underway. We've got the twins, Brielle and Britton Taylor. Interesting enough, they'll be hard to tell apart until we see them emotionally. One is an introvert and one is very feisty.
Absolutely. Young talent here in Atlantic City. It just really shows the growth of the game. It's awesome and exciting to see. And now that beach volleyball is an NCAA sport, gives the youth the hope and the want and the drive to go compete at a college level. And they have the fire in the belly from this age.
And we'll see them going against Emma White and Kaylee Pond, two strong players who are playing in their fifth tournament together. So why don't we get to the action and already underway, the Taylors leading it 2-0.
That was Brielle. Next time, when you wear a hat?
We'll get you.
Brielle back to serve.
David Shaw already having a laugh that there's no telling them apart, Brielle and Britton Taylor.
But you see that twin chemistry on the court. And I mean, we can name a number of twin sisters out here that we've seen at a number of age ranges. It's really neat to be able to play with your sibling. I myself have a little brother, Sean Dennis. We play some co-ed sometime, but you know, don't have that twin telepathy, as one would say. Making the score now 3-0 here on center court.
And we'll get you through the brackets on how these teams got here. Pond and White, Kaylee Pond wearing the green shirt, and Emma White in the gray with the black shorts.
U14 here, these girls just finished eighth grade, going into high school, looking to make their high school teams freshman level club teams. The level has truly raised, I would say, in the last 3 years.
So interestingly enough, with Pond and White, both their parents played volleyball, so these are two that have been around the sport, basically playing since they were learning to walk, basically.
Must be nice, right?
So Taylor and Taylor back to serve, leading it 5-1. Duo from West Palm Beach, Florida, which is where I grew up, by the way.
There you go, shout out.
Off the block, dugout. And Taylor hits it off of White and a point. And we'll switch sides at 6-1. So a great start for Britton and Brielle Taylor.
One thing that you can see at this age specifically is their ball control. You have to have ball control out here in general. But when you know you haven't hit your growth spurt yet and nobody's really blocking balls or pounding it over the net, you have to have ball control. And that's what we're seeing here in their pass set game.
So 6-1 as Taylor tips it over the net. And Pond will just play it over. Chance for a point again. And getting a piece of it was White, but unable to keep it alive. And so a great start for the Taylors.
We got 7-1 here.
I have to laugh on the bracket. Taylor and Taylor are listed from somewhere Florida. Like they didn't know where they were from, so it's somewhere in Florida. So talking to their coach out of West Palm Beach. They play at the Kings Academy.
Somewhere is.
Somewhere.
It, somewhere.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly.
So they're not wrong.
It is accurate. And that one's going to be hit long. Point for Pond and White. White back to serve, talking to her coach, a player with a great vision and a great beach IQ. Good deep serve there. Taylor will play it over. At the net, off the net. Now Taylor tried to tip it down the angle, down the net, and couldn't get it to drop. So a nice little comeback here for Pond and White after falling down 7-1. They now have it 4-7.
Right, she tried to hit that cut shot there. Her elbow was a little bit low, but I love going for the aggressive shot. 4-7.
Or try my favorite, the Kona. That's right.
Taylor dumps it over. Good effort by White, unable to keep it alive. Point for Taylor and Taylor. They beat Corey and Lambert in the semifinals to advance. That was after going through a three-set battle in the quarterfinals. Bumped over, too long. Taylor looks to drop it into the corner, too long. Point for Pond and White.
It is placement over power here at this age, and they are doing a really well job. These are good misses, aggressive misses is what we like to see.
They can watch from wherever they are.
That serve's going to go wide. Point for Taylor and Taylor. It'll be 9-5 as we will switch sides. And we want to remind you, the AVP is proud to use Wilson volleyballs. From the field to the beach, Wilson dominates the sport and is the official ball of the AVP Tour. Learn more at wilson.com. And, of course, David Shaw reading the same announcement to the crowd. We were like, there was an echo.
Hey, it's great to see the teams on the same page here.
That's right, all of us. We're all one big team. Nice crowd out here in Atlantic City, and the weather could not be better. Mishandling the serve there is White and a point, making it 10-5.
We got 10-5 as the Taylor sisters.
Twins on the good side here. Wind is blowing at them, so serve receive. The ball will drop a little bit.
We got 6-10.
Now it'll go 6-10 as White will go back to serve.
Now back to serve from Blue Ridge Volleyball, that's Emma White at the service line.
White serves it deep, and it goes too deep, and a little of that wind probably carrying it too far. And a point for Taylor, and Taylor now at 11-6.
Back to serve.
This is Brielle Taylor, and her serve goes long, so both teams exchanging service errors here. And Pond will go back to serve.
It is so neat for AVP America to be putting on these events for the juniors. Growing up, I'm 26, when there was volleyball being recruited to college, there was no beach.
Right.
We only had indoor. So, of course, we traveled to JO's Junior Olympics and all of those things playing indoors. There was no outlet for beach volleyball yet. And just to see that development here in the U.S. has really helped the depth of the girls' game. I mean, we can even talk about the pros that are playing this weekend. We play tomorrow, Saturday and Sunday. In our bracket, I'm looking at it, and there's depth all the way down. And it's really, I think, prevalent in parallels with making this a collegiate sport.
Which has obviously exploded in turn. College beach volleyball, bigger than it's ever been. Nice play by Pond, dropping it over, and we'll go to the technical timeout. 13-8. Taylor and Taylor lead Pond and White back to Atlantic City in just a moment.
Somehow.
Back in Atlantic City, talking about how great the weather is. I just looked it up. 77 degrees in the middle of summer. Come on now. It feels like 79. Gentle breeze about 8 miles an hour. This is, I'll tell you what, coming from New Orleans, a welcome respite.
Absolutely.
I went for a run this morning, and it was actually felt somewhat easy. It wasn't a complete slog trying to get it done this morning.
Yeah, I kind of feel like I'm home in Hermosa Beach right
yeah.
now.
Yeah, it's awesome. Good effort by White. Can't keep it alive, though. Point for Taylor and Taylor, who lead it 14-8. Pawn and White coming off of a three-set semifinal victory over Haberman and Stewart. Oh, great placement there by Emma White as she hits it over the block and into the corner. Point for White and Pond.
What a swing by Emma there. She hit the ball out in front of her, snapping her wrist high, finding that deep corner.
Taylor off the net, gets it over. White with the dig. White comes to the net and drops it down into the corner. And it is 10-14. So every time it seems like the Taylors might pull away, White and Pond battle back into it, and down four with Pond serving.
Absolutely. They're playing this game one point at a time, one play at a time. We can see it on the court right now, 10 serving 14.
Into the net, Taylor able to get there and able to catch the tape. No, they're going to say it was just out. Looked like it caught the tape from here. So,
11-14.
Yeah, and now the Taylors want to take a look at that. Thought we saw the back line kind of ruffle a little bit there. So,
yes.
Our official kind of come over and take a look. Building the drama here.
Building the suspense. I mean, I know what we saw, but we'll see the call.
Nope, it is going to stay with Pawn and White. So 11 serving 14. Taylor punched over in two by Pawn. Taylor scrambling to the net, and that's going to go wide in another point. For Pawn and White, now 12 serving 14. Funny talking to their coach, that is, as they get the ace serve there. I said, how long have Pawn and White been a team? And he says, oh, forever. And then Emma says, no, it's only been like two tournaments. And then Kaylee says, no, we've been together like six tournaments. And then they're trying to count up which events they actually played together. So.
You know, it blends together you're having fun, right?
Well, even when she was given examples, Emma was like, we played in that? I don't even remember that. 15-13 as we will switch sides. The Taylors have had the lead throughout, but it has shrunk down to two here.
Taylors seem to be strategizing a little bit, or lighting the fire underneath, shall I say, sister to sister. And there's no filter there, you know. You're with your sibling.
Oh, yeah.
You're going home together at the end of
That's
the day.
Right.
So you might say a little bit, talk a little bit differently to each other.
White off of the net, able to recover and hit across her body. Good play. And now a chance as Pond comes to the net. Goes far corner. Great cut shot into the corner. And it is a one-point first set now.
Volleyball, absolutely a game of momentum, as we can see here in the first set here on center court. Never say die.
Taylor can't punch it over, and we're all even at 15. Great effort by Emma White and Kaylee Pond as they have battled back into this and have tied things up at 15. Good serve by White. And now White scrambling to get there, keeps it alive, and now Taylor will just play it over. Chance again for Pawn and White. White will just bump it short. Taylor off the net, go over in two. Longest point of the match so far as Pond goes deep. Taylor able to get it and unable to keep it alive. And the first lead of this first set for Pond and White, and a timeout called by Britton and Brielle Taylor. So after a little bit of a slow start, Pond and White have really fought back and taken over this match a little bit.
Absolutely. They've been steady every single point. It doesn't seem like they're riding emotions right now. It seems that they have a clear-cut job. They know what their mission is for this game, and they look really focused with that narrow vision. The Taylors are a little bit more, you know, riding that emotion. Each player, you know, to each their own, and sometimes you get fired up and you need that. So we'll see how that'll play out here for the rest of the first set.
The AVP would like to thank Waikea Water, founded in Hilo, Hawaii. In Waikea, it is Hawaiian volcanic water that is sustainably sourced and the best tasting water on the planet. Free to you for all our tournament players. To find out more about their mission and purpose, go to waikeaspring.com.
We got 16 serving 15 here. Emma White back to the
Emma slot. White serving with the lead. Taylor's trying to bounce back and turn the momentum, but unable to do so, and it is now a 2-point lead for White and Pond.
So this is where the mental part of the game comes into play, and it is a learning curve. I mean, it is U14. There's a lot going on. You're learning a lot physically on the court and mentally, and that's why they have these coaches, you know, here in their dugouts, per se.
Right.
To help guide them along that journey back to serve.
And a service error, and Taylor is visibly frustrated with herself right now after that service error. 3 points for taking the first set as Pond goes back to serve. Pond with the jump serve. Taylor fought off by Pond. Pond will come to the net and unable to play it over as that set carried her into the net. Wind got behind that a little bit too, it seemed like, and carried it into the net.
Most definitely. The Taylors have had a couple unforced errors here, which let Pond and White come back into this match.
It'll be 17 serving 18 as the Taylors will serve. First of three juniors finals here for you on VSN and AVP.com. Still got the U18s and the U16s to come. Pond, good shot. Now Taylor with a chance for a point, but played it right to White. Now White at the net. And she is able to get the point. Good swing by Emma White.
19-17, White back to serve.
As White will go back to serve.
You can see White's volley IQ as she is moving the ball around in her offense.
Great punch over by Pond and a point, making it 19-17. At this age, obviously, you don't have the growth yet to do the things you can do with the net, but what is away from the net, the things that players this age are still trying to really hone their game on?
Absolutely. Ball control.
Yeah.
Ball control, ball control, and then ball control again. And you can see it here from both teams. It's just being able to minimize those mental errors, those unforced errors. But both teams, I see them looking across the net before they attack the ball, seeing where the other team is, placing it where they're not. So you can see that they are grasping, you know, the visual part of the game as well.
And as you mentioned, the unforced error is a big play or a big key, and an unforced error brings to an end the first set as White and Pond win it 21-17. We'll be back to Atlantic City for the second set. You're watching the AVP Junior Nationals Under 14s on VSN. We'll be right back.
Versace for the cruise, green bottles to the head. My Kenner fully pumping. You got me surfing till my eyes all red.
We welcome you back to Atlantic City, the AVP Junior Nationals, the 14 and unders. We've got one set in the book, Emma White and Kaylee Pond coming back from 5 points down and taking the first set 21-17. They are on the left side, White in the gray shirt and Pond in the green. Good luck telling apart Britton and Brielle Taylor, the twins on the right side of your screen. Paul Bourne, Victoria Dennis with you. Kicking off a big weekend of coverage here on AVP.com and on VSN. First of three juniors finals today, and then we get into the main men's and women's draw tomorrow. Full day of action.
I am so excited to compete tomorrow, Paul.
What time's your match? Do you know yet?
We do not know. We're waiting for the bracket to come out, seeing how the qualifier unfolds this evening.
Taylor able to drop it inside the line, and they lead it 2-1.
Taylor's going back to serve.
White and Pond, both from Virginia, from Winchester and Roanoke, Virginia. As we mentioned, the Taylors from West Palm Beach, Florida. White and Pond at the net. Kept alive momentarily by Taylor, but not the hit she was looking for. And a little bit of frustration seeping in with the Taylors with the unforced errors.
Right, they have to learn, you know, one point at a time. They're very, very talented players, and I have full faith in them that they can stick with it here. They're making great plays at the net. As you can see, swinging high and deep there. Picked up.
White, good play, keeping alive. Pond punches it over and finds the far line for the point.
Pond and White are just finding the court right now, placing the ball where it needs to be. They're painting the sidelines out there, tagging them left and right.
Outstanding hustle and some perfect placement. And they are on a roll right now. And of course, as I say that, airmails the serve and will make the turn three serving four.
I feel like that happens 8 out of 10 times when we say something nice.
I don't know why positivity always turns to negativity. I don't understand why that works out that way.
It's like an announcer's jinx or something.
I really didn't believe in that until I got into the broadcasting.
Right.
It's true. It's dead on.
It's some type of science.
Pond, good bump set. White will tip it over, perfectly played by White.
Soft shot there from Emma White. Kaylee Pond now to serve.
Kaylee Pond now.
We are in set number two of the 14U gold medal match.
Pond from Roanoke, Virginia. White will come to the net. This bump set off of the net, and White was leaning back just a little bit and couldn't get it over.
Big shout out to Chris.
Right, she was below the ball, tried to, you know, get under it to lift it up and over. Sometimes, you know, your timing's just off and you have missed hits, and we see that at all levels of the game.
Pond able to get a fingertip to it and play it over. Now Taylor cuts it, and that'll go wide, and a point for Pond and White. Good idea by Taylor, angling it down the net, but unable to get it to drop down.
Absolutely, that cut shot was dirty from where we're standing. Barely missed the outside of the line there. I would say go after it and do it again.
And that one gonna drop inside the tape, and it'll be five serving six as the Taylors go back to serve. Brielle and Britton Taylor. Coach says, playing wise, they're mirror images of each other, but as we mentioned, the open, one is more feisty than the other one, and the other is more of an introvert.
Which, you know, could help out on the court, you know? The yin and the yang.
Yin and yang, exactly.
Balance.
It's all about being in balance.
Right. On an unbalanced surface.
That's true.
Puns fully intended.
Oh, it'll continue all weekend, I'm sure, too.
Absolutely. Dad jokes for days over here.
8 serving 5 is Kaylee Pond back to serve. Oh, and a little hubby wife there between the two Taylors. And you can tell the feisty one is Brielle, as she was barking at Britton there. And so finding themselves in a 4-point hole, and their coach is trying to rev them up a little bit, because you can tell by the body language a little distraught right now are the Taylor twins.
Right, they need probably a couple of points here to get the wind back under their wings. Going up for the swing.
On with the bump set. White hits it off the net and gets it to drop down. It's all going right for Pond and White right now. As it'll be 10-5.
The recruiting age starts pretty young nowadays. Yeah. I mean, it did when I was in school. I remember getting letters freshman year of high school, and girls were signing end of sophomore year, beginning of junior year. It's a pretty confusing process when you're that age and you don't really know what kind of school you want or what kind of program. And it's just about doing research, and I talk about this with my girls because I coach as well. And also mentor, you know, girls right. that have questions about, you know, the college search and balancing school life. And it's just really neat that you don't have to go D1. There's different outlets. Oh. And there's competition at every level. And being able to academically and physically play out of college is amazing. And being able to compete in sport opens doors for you at your college that you wouldn't normally have. You have access to counselors, you have pick of classes first, and it's really neat to see that. And you know, the route you can go and play at a JUCO and get, you know, some more reps under your belt, and then transfer to D1, 2, 3, NAIA, whatever fits your boat. And yeah, it's a process. And I told them, you know, write your pros and cons throughout the recruiting process, talking to coaches. Don't be afraid to ask for scholarship. Don't be afraid to ask questions in general. So yeah, that's kind of my advice to them while they're going through this process.
Well, and at this age too, a lot of these players don't know if they want to do indoor or outdoor or both at this point.
Totally, and it's about asking those programs what, quote unquote, you're allowed to do, because some schools run them completely different. Some schools allow overlap. So, you know, it's about asking the coaches what is open and what is available. Because if you're undecided, you know, maybe go to a school that'll let you do both. And if you are leaning one way or the other, you can stick at that school and play, you know, beach. Or if you just want to do beach full time, you can always transfer out. There's different options and avenues and accessibility, honestly, at any level.
A serve for Taylor and Taylor as they try to inch back into this as we hit the technical timeout. 12-9 our score, or 9 serving 12 when we come back to Atlantic City on VSN and AVP.com. Back in Atlantic City, the AVP Junior Nationals, the 14 and unders. White and Pond taking the first set and leading the second 13-9. Paul Boren, Victoria Dennis with you. As White will go back to serve. A Again, when this match started, it looked like Taylor and Taylor might run away and hide in this match. Great resilience by Pawn and White to battle back, take the first set, and leading here in the second, and we'll see if the Taylors can go on a run of their own. So they look to keep this match alive, already down one set. Good serve by Taylor. Pawn really had to fight that off, and that put them out of system right off the bat. But somehow able to drop it in. So even when things don't go well, it's going well for Pawn and White right now.
You know, sometimes the universe just puts things in your side of the court there, and we just kind of saw that.
Good serve by Pawn, and Taylor can't do anything with it. And now it is 15-10. So 6 points from taking the under 14 title, and we're going to get a timeout from the Taylors. And while we have the timeout, we want to remind you, Wilson Trophy Company is a proud supplier of our AVP medals. With over 50 years as an industry leader, Wilson Trophy can help bring the sizzle to your event podium. For more information, visit wilsontrophy.com. So desperation time here for the Taylor twins, and they take this timeout, and I guess the reminder is just kind of chip away. You can't get all 5 points back right away, can you?
Right, definitely. If I was in, you know, their dugout right now, I would be telling them to take a deep breath, take it 1 point at a time. I know it's really easy to get frazzled, especially with all the excitement on center court with the music and the stands and the atmosphere. I mean, they are young, so it's just being able to help guide them through this atmosphere that they're in. So just take a breath. It's going to be okay. You know what to do. We've gone through the drills. You know how to pass. You know how to set. Just take it 1 point at a time. And then kind of let the momentum unravel from there.
Carly Pawn back to serve, and another good serve. Taylors will scramble just to get it over, but well played and dropping it in front of White, and that is exactly what they needed.
Also, one thing I would say to both teams and in general to my club teams is let's have constructive dialogue on the court, not just come on, go, you, but specifically, little mishap there. Oh, we're okay. Able to get up and walk that off.
Yeah, a little heavy collision between Pawn and White. And White a little frazzled by the whole thing. Thought that we were on a changeover as well.
That'll happen.
But she seems to be okay. But that's like two outfielders in baseball both going for the same ball and just running into each other. And that's exactly what happened right there. Oh, great. Oh,
wow. That's a great shot, honestly. There's nothing you can do about that play. Great cut shot there by Pawn.
Basically using the outside of her hand, right, and just kind of punching it almost.
Yep. Just a little boop over the net. Sometimes that's all you need.
Works just as fine as bringing the heat.
They're both 1 point.
Yeah, exactly. The Taylors down four, looking to get the serve back on their end, but another unforced error, and 4 points from winning the match now are Pawn and White. Emma White to serve. Great serve, and that'll be a chance for another point as Pawn sets White, and White goes deep corner. Great dig by Taylor, and now they got to scramble to get it over. They do so. Now it is Pawn at the net, going angle and dropping it in. 18-12 for Pawn and White.
Emma White back to serve.
Great effort by the Taylors, but they find themselves in a 6-point hole now. And that one able to carry over, and 13 serving 18 now.
Big momentum push here at the service line.
Yep, got to get a couple here, get back into it. And a joust at the net. And it goes into the antenna, and so it'll be a point for Pawn and White. 19-13. Going to be an unforced error, and now we are at match point for Pond and White.
Pond standing catty corner to where the wind is blowing right now. That's a great volley IQ as she's driving the ball into the wind to the opposite corner, looking for it to drop.
Can they stay alive at the net? Dropped over, good dig by White. Pond goes over in two. Taylor fights it off, but Pond and White are your 14 and under junior national champions.
Britton Taylor
and Brielle Taylor gave it a great effort, but Pond and White come storming back, and some of their friends are out to congratulate them as they win here in Atlantic City in the under 14 junior nationals. Congratulations to them.
Absolutely, and great job to both teams making it this far in the tournament, and good luck to them for the rest of their career here. And next tournament, right?
Right.
It is summer.
Right. There's always another tournament, right? So we'll step aside for a moment, and then Victoria and I will put a wrap on this 14 and under final. You're watching the AVP Junior Nationals on VSN and AVP.com. Paul Boren, Victoria Dennis back with you. Just wrapping up the 14 and unders. And boy, we talk about momentum, and the Taylors had all the momentum, and then White and Pond grasped it and didn't let it go.
Absolutely. They stayed steady through the entire match. You could see their volley IQ. They were placing the ball where it needed to be, looking at the other side of the court. And they just were steady, honestly, at the end of the day. They didn't ride a lot of emotion. Both teams played excellent volleyball here in Atlantic City, and it really just shows growth of the youth game.
Victoria and I will be back in just a few minutes as we'll have the 18 and under finals coming up. You are watching AVP Volleyball on VSN and AVP.com.